Damn, I think he saw me. Oh, he's seen me as well. I'm meant to be stealth.
How you doing, mate? All right? Yeah, I'm fine. Oh, when I get up. So, what's your favourite camera for street photography? I mean, there's a lot of different cameras out there, digital and film, and I'm sure that many of us would look at a camera and say, yeah, that's the best one for street photography, or this or that or the other. But what's the best one that you've got, or what one do you use for street photography? Sometimes I get a little bit confused with the cameras that I want to use for street photography, and I'll tell you why. The other week I went back to my hometown in southeast London and I wanted to go out on the streets and take some photographs. I took with me the Nikon F3 and a nice 50mm Zeiss Milvus lens on as well, so it made it look quite big. And I was getting some nice photographs, but I was walking through some different back streets and stuff, and all of a sudden I felt a little bit paranoid, if you like. There was lots of little, you know, lots of these little tiny young gangsters hanging around, and I thought, crikey, I looked at the camera, looked at the lens, I thought maybe I could possibly be a target for a potential snatch, you know, to run past and grab me camera, even though I had a camera strap on. And it got me thinking, is this really sensible to walk around with this sort of camera around certain streets, especially suburbs of London? Today, I'm in Cowes on the Isle of Wight. I'm at Cowes on the Isle of Wight, which is a yachty place. I could walk around this all day long with the most expensive camera in the world and no one's going to nick it off me, so I'm quite happy. But having said that, I wanted to know myself if I could get used to any other cameras for street photography. Whenever I go for a shoot on the streets, I often end up looking for interesting compositions and angles of objects already on the street. And if I feel that I need a person to fill the frame, I'll wait for someone interesting to walk by. I like to be a bit inconspicuous too, and almost make out as though I'm more interested in what's in front of me than the person walking into the frame. I try and make the photograph more about the object than the people. And if I like the look of someone, I often politely ask if I can take their photo, in a non-creepy way, of course. I'll usually explain that I'm documenting the people and times of the area on old cameras as a personal project, and usually people don't mind. Now, these people ain't got a clue that I'm taking pictures of them. They think I'm taking pictures of this bike, but they are in my subject. So I've brought out with me couple of really simple cameras that no one's going to bother nicking if I was in London. The little Rolly LED, fantastic camera, lovely little lens, 40mm lens, fixed lens, fully manual camera. And also this old beauty as well, the Fed 2, a little bit like the Leica, early Leicas. In fact, I've got an early Leica lens on here as well. And I brought this one out with me too. And I think these sort of cameras have got maybe two advantages of street photography. One is they don't look intimidating whatsoever. So if I'm walking around the streets taking photographs and I want to pop a quick shot of someone doing something, it doesn't look intimidating. I don't look like I'm working for the local press or I'm a serious paparazzi shooter or whatever, for people to have some sort of hostile confrontation, you know. These are just real simple cameras. And the other benefit is these ain't going to get nicked out of my hands if I'm in London or somewhere, or another city in the UK or around the world. You know, good luck if they want to try and nick one of these. They'll probably get about 10 quid, if that, on the street value for it.
And usually for street, I stick with a camera that's not too heavy or bulky. Take the Nikon F5, an amazing camera, but a beast to carry about all day. And it's hardly inconspicuous and possibly attractive to potential snatchers. That's if they can run that fast with a Nikon F5. And here I'm rubbing down the metalwork, not because it's dirty. I'm making out as though I'm focusing on the stairs and not the people, just so I don't look any more creepy.
But sometimes these sort of cameras, not so much this one, but these sort of cameras can sometimes start up conversations with people as well. They see you using one of these and they go, oh, what's that? You know, and then you say, it's an old Fed 2, it's a film camera, blah, da, 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 da. And then they get talking about film. Oh, can you still buy a film? Do you develop it yourself? And you get into this conversation. And generally there was a photographer from the past, and they'll start telling you stories about their day. And I find that quite nice to talk to people about film, strangers that I don't even know. So, but above all, I'd be interested to know what any of you guys use for street photography. And when I say street photography, I don't mean running up to people's faces and taking pictures pictures of strangers and scaring the hell out of them. I'm talking about anything that you do in suburban areas, in around streets or urban photography, anything like that. What's your sort of camera that you walk around with? And do you feel safe walking around with it, that it's not going to get snatched out of your hands? So I've been around the town taking a few shots on the Fed 2, and you guys have got to remember, I've also got a video camera and a tripod next to me as well. So wherever I go, this tripod and camera's coming with me as well. So it's not too inconspicuous. People are often up and down looking at me because they're inquisitive in what I'm doing. If I was here without all the vlogging equipment, then I'd be a lot less inconspicuous. So it's quite tricky when you're doing these sort of videos for YouTube, for you guys to see, because I'm videoing at the same time. So in a moment, I'm gonna put that GoPro and tripod in my car and then go off on the streets and do some street photography. Don't forget, I'm carrying that thing in front of me everywhere. So I've got one hand with the camera, one hand on the GoPro. But so far, so good. I've taken a few shots with this one and a few creative shots and whatnot. And my idea sometimes, you know, if I wanna get people in my shot, they've gotta look a little bit interesting, you know? Bit quirky, a bit different. Everywhere I go around here, everyone's looking the same, you know, normal coats, normal jeans, trainers, whatever. It doesn't really float my boat if I want to make any prints, but I'm always looking for something unusual. There's a lady walking past. You see, I missed that shot because I'm chatting away. She looked quite quirky. But I usually plot up and find a composition somewhere and wait for someone to come into that composition. It might take a while for the right person to come along, and sometimes no one comes along at all. So, you know, you get what you can. But I enjoy this sort of photography, walking around the streets, watching the hustle and bustle of people in their everyday lives and just taking photographs. You notice back there, I was getting some shots behind railings and whatnot. So people are thinking that I'm taking a photograph of something else and not them, but I'm actually filling the whole frame with something and getting people in the background at the same time. But as I say, you know, dogs are quite nice. If you see people walking dogs, that can make quite an interesting picture. But I'm always looking for something that I can print at the end of the day as well, maybe put at home on the wall. So I don't really want anyone's face recognizable if that's gonna happen. So maybe the back of somebody, mysterious looking, maybe a slower shutter speed. So there's so much you can do if you just stop for a moment and think about what you want, especially with film, because I've only got a certain amount of shots to take. I can imagine this Fed camera being really fun to use out on the streets. It's a beautiful camera to look at, and the clockwork on it is so smooth. The advancing on it is smooth, the shutters are smooth, and the rangefinder, when you look through, is although it's quite small on the window there, it's actually quite bright when you look through, and it works pretty well. Over the years, the rangefinder has held up well. I can see everything coming in into line. And there's also a little tiny diopter as well, so you can focus it and adjust it to your eyes, but I keep knocking it when I'm out shooting and everything goes out of focus. And this classic vintage Elmar Lights lens, although not very fast for a 50mm lens at just 3.5, it could give me some vintage looking prints. And I don't think the lens is coated, so it's giving me sort of flat contrast. So it is what it is. It's a brilliantly built vintage lens. I would say that something like this is an ideal camera for walking around the streets, trying to be unobtrusive and stress-free as well. You're not going to worry, you know, about being a potential target to any thieves when you've got a camera like this. And if you look online, you can see these cameras are pumping out around about £50 to £100 with a lens as well. Not this particular lens, but other lenses that come with these cameras. But they're great fun to use. Just one word of warning, like some of these older cameras, you can break the internal mechanisms if you change the shutter speed once you've advanced. So at the moment, it's already advanced and it's set to a particular shutter speed. I'm now safe to change the shutter speed. If I advance and then want to change the shutter speed, I've got, you know, I could damage the internal components of the camera, so I'm not going to take anything to chance. Although a couple of times I've accidentally done it and I ain't seen any problems yet. So I've bought out today another one, the CANON CE5 camera, which cost me about £50. So if I'm shooting this in London or any other city and I'm in a dodgy area and it gets snatched out of my hand. All I've lost really is the camera and the lens and a roll of film. Nothing too expensive. The Rolly LED had a slight problem with it. When I went to rewind the film back, it wasn't rewinding back, although I thought it had rewound back, so I had to open the back and take a little sneak peek inside to see if the film had gone back into the cassette, and it hadn't, which caused a few light leaks. But it's broken, the rewind crank on it is actually broken, so I've got to get that fixed. But other than that, it is a fantastic camera, but I just felt like I couldn't get too creative with it. Fine, ideal for, you know, anything quick and easy, like, I don't know, a protest or something like that, where you want to just keep snapping away. But to get a little bit more creative, I didn't feel it was going to cut the mustard. And this camera's got a nice 50mm coated Chinon lens on it as well. So I'm going to give this one a little try out. Obviously, I've shot this plenty of times before, but I'm going to take some street photographs now around here. In fact, I'm not even on the street. I'm down the beach, but there's plenty of people, plenty of dogs, plenty of life, plenty of activity going on.
I don't think this camera is too in your face. It's light, it has a good light meter inside, and I can focus through the lens, leaving less out of focus photos to chance. With the other two cameras, I was zone focusing mostly and using the Sunny 16 rule. But I did have one problem with this camera.
So you can see me sitting down there at the moment. I'm just waiting for these moped scooters to come by. It might make a nice photograph. To be honest with you, I'm a little bit stuck at the moment for compositions, and there's nothing down there that's floating me boat. And the GoPro's right over there. People are walking past me, think I'm talking to myself. They think I'm mental. I've got a problem with this camera now. This one's out the window. So I don't know what happened there. I'm on auto mode, meaning I'm in aperture priority. Went to take the picture, it didn't fire. Went to take a second picture, it didn't fire, and all of a sudden it fired when I didn't want it to. Is this camera starting to play up on me?
And looking at the Chinon CE5 camera, it's probably ideal if I want to go off to some of these cities and walk around some of the back streets where I'm not too familiar. And I don't think it's the sort of camera that anyone's going to be following me or targeting me for. It looks like a film camera. It doesn't look expensive. It is a little bit noisier than the others. The beauty with the Rolly and the Fed 2 is that they're very, very quiet shutters. So no one knows that you've taken a picture. With this one, it's working, by the way. You can hear it click away. And I've been on streets sometimes and people have heard the click and gone, are you taking a picture of me? And you're like, yeah, I was, mate. You know, but... The problem I had with this camera, I realised, if you notice the way I'm holding it, just there is the timer. You can see it, it's the timer just there. And I was accidentally tripping the timer halfway, so not enough for it to fully go off, but enough for it not to fire. That's what I was doing. I had the camera in my hands for about half an hour last night, trying to figure out what was wrong with it. That was the problem. I'm really pleased, because that means that this camera's working and good to go. And if I put the timer back in place, it fires. So that was the problem. But yeah, before any of you guys sign out, if you've been watching this, let us know in the comments what your feelings are when you're out with your cameras in certain areas. Do you feel the way I feel sometimes? Also, let us know what cameras you use for most of your street photography. If you want to stick around, I'm going to make some prints. I'll start off with that one where I was down next to the bicycles, right where the wheels were, where that flat tire was. That's what actually drew me to the cycles in the first place, was the one with the flat tire. I just thought it looked a little bit different, and that's when I plotted up. I would like to have got the spokes in the foreground more in focus, but I was so close and it just wasn't going to happen. And this is a small, simple 3D printed easel from Bit by Bit Photo out in Texas. He sent me one of these and a couple of other bits for the channel. These are absolutely fantastic, these little things. Ideal for making these little 10x8 prints in my darkroom. So this is 10x8 paper I'm using, and it's a 35mm neg. So if I want the whole 35mm negative on 10x8, I'm going to need to zoom in, if you like, so the whole negative sits on the paper. But I haven't done that. I've cropped into the part that I like.
and that's where I'm going. Just done my tests, so it's only 3.5 seconds. We'll do that now. Shouldn't need any burning or dodging or anything like that on this. I've got a contrast grade 2.5 filter underneath, so let's do that now. Off it goes. Hopefully it's still in focus. And I've got to say a massive shout out to the guys that support me on Patreon and the YouTube members area as well, and to buy me a coffee. It helps me in the darkroom get paper and chemicals and stuff for me to be able to play around like this and show you guys what I'm up to in the darkroom and continue making videos. So massive thank you to everyone that supports the channel. I really do appreciate it. That's coming out all right. So this is Kentmere VC Select glossy paper that I'm using. So I've gone for a gloss this time. Usually I'm printing on matte. I'm not being too critical myself in the darkroom, just making a couple of prints and seeing how they come out. Just a bit of home printing and a bit of fun. They don't look too bad at all. Could have done with a little bit more contrast. And that was from the Fed 2 camera, which I noticed the lens on that. I don't know too much about them old lenses, but I don't think it's got any coating for any decent contrast on it. But that's something we can always do in Photoshop or in the darkroom if I wanted to. Yeah, it looks nice. It looks quite nice. I could have done with a little bit more contrast, but then I feel a bit more contrast would have started to make the blacks a bit too black, I think. I can't remember what colour this bike was, but the back tyre there, that's certainly black. His jacket's black, so I think I've got all the blacks there that I need. So I've had a nice afternoon session in my darkroom and I've managed to make a few prints. It's always nice to come back, especially from a street photography, with a few negatives that you can make prints of and see them come to life on paper. This is one of them. I quite like this one with the puddle on the floor. People looking at me must have thought, what is that weirdo doing? But only photographers know what we're doing, right? Or maybe not. Maybe I'm just odd. Anyway, I did a little tiny bit of dodging on the puddle just to make it highlight a little bit more. You can see. I think that's quite a nice print there that I've made. The motorbikes, the mod boys, I think that was the only decent one that I got of them. A little tiny bit, he was moving around quite a bit. I think this is 1/25 of a second. So a little bit of motion on his helmet, but that doesn't matter at all. It's it's a moment these guys are moving around. It's quite a nice photograph, I think. Plenty of blacks and going on there. And that was with the CANON CE5 camera, which I think's got a bit more contrast because of that coated lens. And another one with the CANON CE5, that was the Bulldog, quite like that one. You notice his face is a little bit light. You probably didn't notice until I put it down and told you. I just used a dodge tool over that just to cover about a second so that it highlights his face a bit more. What a beautiful dog, eh? He wouldn't sit still either. We're back to the Fed 2 camera, and that was the shot there where I got right behind that classic old racing bike. This isn't modern, this one's probably about 30 years old. That's why I got the photograph of it. A couple of people in the background, and you can notice it's a little bit less contrast than the CANON C5. I think that Fed 2 lens, or the Leica lens I should say, on that camera hasn't got any coating, so the contrast is naturally a little bit flat. I could deal with that in the print, but I didn't bother. And one of my favourites was the little tiny dog in the doorway. Notice it's a little bit dark around the edges. What I've done, I've burned in the edges a little bit more to kind of vignette it, but I think I went a bit too nuts, so I can highlight the dog more. Still looks quite nice, but I did another one, and this one's more flat. Again, this is on the Fed 2 camera, and you can see my obvious dodging area around the dog there. I don't mind this haloing on some of my prints. Some people don't like it. I don't actually mind that, and sometimes I do it just for the purpose of it. And like any cameras, when you're not used to them, it takes time to try and find its sweet spot. But I think the thing about this camera, it's not aggressive looking. It doesn't stand out in a crowd. And anyone that knows their cameras might even stop by and say, oh, crikey, you've got an old Fed camera. You know, strikes up a little bit of conversation about a hobby that you love. So next time that I plan a shoot in London or any other city and I'm thinking about walking off into the back streets, getting lost as usual, I'm not going to worry or be stressed too much with a camera like this or a camera like this as I was with the Nikon F3. I don't think these are aggressive cameras. They're not obtrusive. You know, you don't stand out in a crowd with these sort of cameras. And I think they're sensible for street photography, particularly if you're not too used to the area.
and you just want to walk around the streets taking pictures. Let us know in the comments, guys, what you think. Let me know what cameras you use for your street photography. If you do, do you worry about it? Let us know. It's always good to read your comments, and thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.